Hey guys, Buck here with BTM Scale Modeling, and we are getting a lot done this week on the bench. Got all the lighting set, saucer section and the secondary hull. I have a couple more strands to hook up to the aft section by the shuttle bay, but for all intents and purposes, we are done with lighting, so now we can start getting things hooked together, getting the spaghetti mess, as you will see in the video, cleaned up. We did some testing, which you'll see in the video, so I encourage you to stick around and watch it. So the plan for the next week on the bench is to actually start getting parts put together so we can get the bondo work done and get stuff cleaned up, so we can get some paint laid down. One interesting fact, if you guys remember from last week, I told you I found a situation that I was going to run into, and that is the red and green navigation lights along with the internal lighting for the windows. I'm going to have to go back onto my base and add another switch so that I can just turn those on. And you know, keep everything plugged in so it has power. I can just turn those on, and then we can go into the effects of the tenant control boards, which are really cool, which you'll see some of the tests I did on this week. So guys, I encourage you to keep following me. If you're a new subscriber, thank you for watching the channel. You can also follow me on Facebook at BTM Scale Modeling. On Google Plus, BTM Scale Models or BTM Scale Modeling. I still, I gotta go in and change the name, I think, on Google Plus. Also, I have an Instagram page now at BTM Scale Modeling. So guys, I will post regular updates throughout the week, pictures that I'm doing. So there's that. So as always, guys, please, I like hearing from y'all, so leave a comment in the comment section. If there's something you need to know more about, a technique that I did that I didn't go over well enough for you, please let me know. If you guys have some tips, please, I encourage you, let me know. This community, as I always say, is about helping each other and creating great model kits. So without further ado, let's get to the bench. Hey guys, it's Monday afternoon. Or more evening. Getting ready to go to work here in a little bit, but thought I'd show you what's going on. Got some more done yesterday. Started working on the saucer section. Let me pull your tool here out. So guys, right now what I have all wired up and pretty well in place is the red and green navigations, the white strobe lights, and the registry light. Same going on here. White strobe, red, and green navigation lights. As you can see, I've already kind of put down LED strip tape. It's not glued in place yet. I'm just kind of looking to see what I want to do here. As you can see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, possibly going to be 6 after I black this out, or I might have to run another LED right in here with this glue. We'll have to see. Hopefully I can get enough light. I might run one right here, but I'm hoping there's enough ambient light from both the bottom and the top. Again, as you can see, right now I'm setting placements down on the lower part of the saucer. Again, these will help light up this interior. These along the edge will help light up around the outer side of the saucer, while these will help light this up and then give me enough ambient light to go through the entire saucer section. So what I'm getting ready to do now is I'm going to add in the orange LEDs for the kit that, or for the lighting kit Ralph supplied, and that's going to be the phasers. Now Ralph did it to where you can fire, you know, do the phaser out of the back phaser banks right here. I'm going to still do one back here, but a lot of times in the show you'll see I'm firing from here. So basically all I did was drilled a hole and routed it out just a bit. I want the bulb to stay recessed. That way, when I paint the phaser bank, one, I can take care of the bulb, but it's the bulb's not taking away from the phaser bank, it's enhancing it. So, what am I getting ready to do? Like I said, I'm getting ready to do that, then I'm going to start applying my wiring. So, with that said, basically what I'm going to do is run connection, 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 or I'm going to actually start with this one in here and run connection from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, and then run this out. The plan is I'm going to leave enough wiring that I can group everything together and get it down to a couple of single strands. Now, like the phaser banks are going to be on their own because they go to two different parts on the board. The strobe lights will be together, but they'll be coming out and tying in with the aft section and the secondary hull, and then the navigation and the white light is all going to be on the same circuit. So that's the plan. So I'm going to keep working, but just want to give you guys a heads up, and we'll come back once I get that all done and then test the lighting and see what you guys think. All right, see you in a bit. Hey guys, it's Wednesday and we're continuing work with the Voyager, getting some stuff done before I get to go in tonight. Took a rest day from working out. Tell you what, I have added CrossFit to mine and my son's workout, and man, I tell you, that thing kicks our butt, but that's a good thing. So, wanted to show you what I've been working on. So without further ado, I'll just get some power going here and we'll turn the light off. So yes, it's the top part is done, and I'll flip it over here in just a second. I like that, it's very adamant. I still have to do light blocking on the navigations and the strobes and some of that, but I'm wanting to get a majority of all the wiring done, and what I'm gonna do is here in a minute, I am going to bring down the lower part of the saucer and show you my technique for wiring in LED strip tape into a big area. But guys, that's that so far, and I think I like the effect. So just so you know, I got a hint when I was working on the Enterprise D on how to do the lighting. The biggest thing is, well, here, let me just show you real quick, guys. So if we take this up to 12 volts, you can see how bright and sometimes it just like, wow, it's really out there. Or we run it to 9 volts, which is what I'm gonna run the whole kit on, is 9 volts. The lighting comes down, it's more subtle, it's more into scale with the kit. So my suggestion, guys, you can do what you want, but a subscriber let me know that running at 9 volts brings the lighting more into scale. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna flip this over and probably flood the camera with the light, but show you. So this is what it looks like with it all lit up, as you can tell. Let's take this off, power down so you're not flooded out, and show you what's going on here. Let's see if I can do this. Okay. So, as you guys can see, I have all the strip tape in, and I wired it in. Now, what I've done is I picked a start point, which is right up here in deck one and deck two, and I started there. And then basically all I'm doing is running in series is, I think that's the right terminology, in series. And basically I'm just running one power negative all the way through the tape. So it's just one line. So I don't have to have a conglomeration of wires. I can just run it out. And then what I did is, this is where I'm gonna make my connection at with the lower saucer, right back here. So this is the one lead now. Now, like I said, what it does is it keeps it clean. Now I have to go in and glue it down a little bit better. But what it does is it just keeps it really clean, keeps it really neat. I mean, as you can see, there's a lot going on here. I have the phasers, I have the navigation, and then I have the marker designated light, and then the two strobe lights. What the plan is once I get all this wired in and glued down, when I get ready to seal this up for the final time, is I will glue all these down into place and run my wires. I'm kind of keeping everything up loose from the connections right now, so I know what's going on. But let me get reset and I will show you how I make a connection run with LED strip tape. So stand by, guys. Okay guys, welcome back. We have the lower saucer, and as you can see, I've got the strip tape kind of where I want. Pretty much this is how it's going to lay out. So I got the two back here on this part to bring light, a little bit more light into this area right here. And then the two running long ways, make sure that this on the outer edge gets all well lit, and then the middle one, make sure everything comes up, and I think that's going to work really well. So basically the first thing you really need to do is, like I said, make sure your tape's laid out where you want it, where you think you want it. I've done enough of these starships now that I've lit, and between Battlestar Galactica builds and the starships, I've gotten pretty well where I know. The biggest thing is sometimes, guys, like I learned on the Enterprise D, sometimes I didn't put in enough lighting. So I probably went a little bit overboard, but I just want to make sure that I get that effect. So the first thing you want to do is make sure you got your soldering iron good and hot and ready to go, and pick a start point. The biggest start point right now is, what we're going to do is we're going to go in and we're going to get some solder on these strip tapes. Sometimes these things just don't like me. Yeah. Sometimes you get big blobs. Sometimes you get, I gotta get a new soldering gun. So if you guys have some suggestions, I would love it, because this is just a $20 special from Home Depot, and I'd really like to look at investing in a really good soldering iron. So you guys, if you have a good suggestion, please send it my way, so I can give it to my wife for Christmas ideas. But as you can tell, all I'm doing right now is I'm just running little beads of solder onto the connection points. And the biggest thing, again, with this, with doing this, you don't want to spend a lot of time with heat on the tape. You can burn it out, and I've done that before. So you just want to get in real quick and get it in. Don't worry, sometimes, you know, you get big globs, you get little globs. Just try to get some solder down. If you need to, you can add more later. Like, I'll go back and I'll look at a couple of these spots, like, yeah, that might need just a little bit more. So that's the first step I do. Now, as you've noticed, none of these are glued down yet. I haven't hot glued them in place. The big reason for that is, as I go through, I test each one after I make a connection, and once I've tested it and it's good, then I'll glue it in place. Like, you get something like that, and that way if the connection or I have to replace the tape, I'm not fighting hot glue trying to pull things up. Is out of the way. So now the funny thing is, I might not use all the connections here, but it's a good idea to get a good idea where we're going. So, next, just pull out a few strands of random wire, you know, one that you can keep, you know, track of. Right now I'm just using, I got some purple wire that I'm going to use. And basically, the idea is, how do I want to do it? Do I want to go around the edge and then come back up here and then over to here to this connection? Figure out a plan. I'm going to go from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, from here. Let's see here. 1, 2, boom, 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 boom. Or I can go boom, boom. Because I don't want to double the wire in, and that's the biggest issue, is how do I want to do this? So up, up, over to here, from here to here, from here to here, and then from here. Okay, so that's the plan. So the first thing, I don't try to trim it down to what I'm going to need right off. I like to keep the strands long, and you'll see why. Because if you're trying to mess with short wire, it just really becomes a, you know, if I try to cut this piece, and it just becomes a real pain in the butt. So let me try to zoom in here a little bit so you can see what's going on right there. Okay, so basically the first thing I do is I'll run my positive. It doesn't really matter which direction you go, what you hook up first. So we'll hook that in. I'll strip a little bit off of this one. And we'll hook that in. Again, you don't need much, just enough to get it there. Let it cool down a second. And don't throw your soldering iron everywhere. And you guys can probably tell, I leave strands. Like I said, that gives me just enough room to, you know, so I can work with this. And it's pretty simple. The cleanup here is you take your snips and you go back in and just trim that wire down. I always trim it down because I don't want a chance when I go back to glue it that when I go to press down to get the glue flat that it's going to cross and then we'll short it out. So here I'm gonna make the jump, and as you can tell, I don't need a whole lot, but what I'm gonna do is, as you can see, I measure it out and then I'll cut just a little longer and we'll strip it with our wire wrap tool. And play with everything, you know. Okay, and then what I do is I just put it down to the edge. Like I said, I don't mind having that little bit of leftover. And watch your fingers. And then I just touch it down, make sure the solder gets melted. And then there we go. Now that's another connection made. Same thing with the negative. I kind of cut it longer than I need. So I can make the connection. Like I said, be careful though when you're doing this. Like I said, this 30AWG likes to break sometimes. So I try not to move this as much or as little as possible. So sometimes with it short like this, it tends to like to play on me to get it in here. So sometimes I'll, and then when I trim, I cut off a little bit more than I know I'm going to need on the trim part. So I have enough wire when I go to do this. And then I'll just fold that connection over, come back in, touch the solder iron, make the connection, and there we go. So these small jumps like this, yeah, they can be a pain. Just take your time. Be steady. Be careful. Don't try to give yourself second or third degree burns with the soldering iron. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this connection up here. Let that get in there getting tight. Get my positive wire. Do the same thing. Okay, then what you want to do, after you make a connection to a new piece of tape, you want to test it. Now, I didn't test it on that back one because I wanted to go ahead and get this first two wired in together. And what happened is, if I did everything right, then we should get some nice light. And there we go. So that's how I do this. So I'm going to pause, and I'm gonna do my favorite thing of time lapse, and show you how and finish wiring this lower saucer section up. Okay guys, I'll see you when we get done. Hey guys, one thing before we go to the time lapse I was gonna show you and I didn't. Once you test the connection, go ahead and glue down like I'm doing here, and basically what you want to do is just a little thin strip. But what you really want to do, and not get glue on your fingers, get it right here, is, if you can see where my finger's pointing, this connection right here. What you want to do is where you make the wire connections to the LED strip tape, be generous, not too zealous generous, but generous with the glue. Because like I said, that hot glue is really going to protect the connection points. So again, same thing, as it cools down, once it cools down to a certain point, go through, press down, and get that glue really, really flat. So, guys, there's that, and now I'm gonna get reset, and our set, and we're gonna do a little time lapse. Okay, guys, that's basically 101 on how I do light strip tape when I'm wiring in a bunch. Got connections made just to give you a broad view of what we've just done. And sorry if it washes out on you, but sorry, there we go. The marker lights, it's coming through really well right here. On the lower saucer, I really like that, and then on the top, it's phenomenal. Yeah, we do got some light leaks we definitely will have to take care of, but we still have to finish getting everything down. It looks really good. Let me cover that up right here on where we added the extra windows. Looks phenomenal, but I'm happy with that. That's quite a good amount of light coming through. As you can tell here, the bulb I used, it doesn't go down far enough. It still gives a great effect, but I like that. So guys, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take this back apart and get some final detail wiring done, and I will walk you through that. But I thought you'd like to take a sneak peek of saucer section is pretty well all wired up, and now we're going to do, like I said, do some light blocking, finish up tagging some wires. But that looks really, really good. And then we'll go in after we get this all painted up and take care of the windows, get them with some crystal clear in them. But I'm very, very happy with that, guys. So I'm going to take care of those things, and I'll see you when we come back. Hey guys, it's Saturday and we're continuing work on Voyager. I did upload some photos, I'm pretty sure all you guys saw. Yes, the light flare was pretty bad from my phone. In person it doesn't look really that bad. I might have got a little overzealous with the LED strips into the saucer section. But like I said before, sometimes it's a learning curve. I like it. It looks really good in person, so the camera did flare up pretty bad. But once we get all the light blocking finished and we start adding the micro crystal clear to the windows, that'll help tone it down quite a bit. Unlike the Enterprise kit that I built previously, none of those windows were drilled out, so we had that diffusing from the clear plastic, where this, everything's drilled out until we put in the crystal clear. So finishing up on this weekend, before I put this together, I am going to go ahead and finish cleaning up the wiring. As you guys can tell, there's kind of a nice little spaghetti mess going on here. I just got everything into place to get everything tested. Now I'm going back through cleaning it up, doing my leads. I also have to finish doing light blocking on the navigation and strobes, the same with the upper saucer, get those all cleared up and painted black so we don't get that. Basically guys, I'm almost done with installing the lighting. I still need to finish putting the wires onto this strip, these two strips, so we can make sure we get light back here. And then I need to run two LED strip tapes in here. Basically, it's going to go in like this towards the bottom. So with those four, that should give me plenty of light into the secondary hull, which is awesome, because this is, the lighting seems to take the most, getting it all run, getting all the wires. So then I got to finish doing light block. Also, a side note, guys. If you do the bulkhead like I did, even though I trimmed it down, show you guys here real quick. As you can see, I've marked a line where that bulkhead's going to go. I'm just going to go in here real quick and just trench this out to a point, lightly trench it out so I know I have a good set, because with the resistors and everything, I don't want to have to press super hard down to make sure I get that fit. And then I gotta light block that. Also, for me, what I am doing is I've drilled a pilot hole right here. I'm gonna enlarge this hole a little bit. and run all the wiring down through here into the secondary hall, because basically, guys, once it gets put on, I don't want to have to try to reroute that back in there. Like I said, guys, we're gonna have to put this kit pretty much all together to get it painted. There's just too many sections, and the problem is once I put in this back spine, the spine, and get the saucer, there's a really bad seam right here, and the same with the spine that goes right here. There's got to be extensive Bondo work done. So yeah, there's that. So I'm gonna continue to work, and I'll come back with some thoughts for what's next. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay, guys, we're back. So I thought before I get all the wiring tied down and put together, I better test some things. So I've got the phasers wired up, and I got the photon torpedoes wired up to the boards. So it's really cool. I mean, it is really cool. But just so you guys know, this one's really good. This one, when I went to do the blackout blight blocking paint on the back, I guess I didn't get the glue all the way around enough, so it got black into the bulb. I can see it up front, but you can't see it off the camera, so I still got some cleanup work to do there. But you can see this one, and you can see the photon torpedoes, so it looks really, really cool. So I'm gonna douse the light, and first up is the photon torpedoes. And let me adjust this just so you can see that a little better. That is cool. And then the phasers. Like I said, this one is firing, so I know it's right. It just got a little paint on it, and I didn't get it up as far as I thought I did. It's either here or there, but I really liked it. The front one you can see really well, so it looks really good. So when I put this in, I just recessed it. My plan was just to recess it a little bit, so it looks like it's really coming out of the bank instead of on top of the bank. Maybe I recessed this back one a little too much, but one more time. Photon torpedoes. And phaser. So. Awesomely cool. So, guys, for all intents and purposes, the lighting is done. I still have to wire the LEDs up here for the back half of the secondary hull. I do have the LED strip tape wired and put into the secondary hull, and we have successfully tested the phasers and the soundboard. Now, the cool thing is, even though the effects aren't there because I don't have everything wired up, you can still hear the warp effect. And then the ramp up still there. So, Ralph, amazing product. And torpedoes. So, guys, it is coming together. I mean, the hardest part right now is getting all the lighting installed, and now, since that's all wired up, I got to clean it up and get it glued down into place to look better, to get some of the combobulated spaghetti done. I still, like I said, got to clean that up. But hey, I'm happy with where we're getting at. So I'm going to keep going on. And this is where this video for this week's going to end, on the high note of testing the phasers and the photon torpedoes. And we got a lot of work done this week. So, guys, I will see you next week on the bench when we get further along. Thank you for watching. Thank you for allowing me to show you the love that I have for this hobby. And we'll see you next week on the bench. Fire.